would start the story straight away. I'm Steve. This is about my fourth Pan-African book foundation. Yes, event. It started off at, anyone remember the early days? Anyone been here more than, is this your first time here? Anyone been here more than once?
First time.
Anyone been here for a second or third time? No. Oh, you have. Where was it? Last year.
It was here.
It was here last year?
Yeah, just upstairs.
And before that? Yeah.
I was here.
We're all quite new here, apparently.
Pardon?
We're all quite new here, apparently.
Yes, all right, yeah, it's fine. I'm good, because you weren't have played this before. This is the story I told about 4 years ago, and then maybe again the year after. I try and do different stories each time. Before, last year was here, but the time before was in one of those churches in Wandsworth. Yeah, what it's called. And the year before that, at Christchurch, Barry Bowen, near Peckham. And I told this story then. And it's, there are many Anansi stories. Just before I forget, I better turn my phone off. There are many Anansi stories. Has anyone, who's heard of the story of Anansi? Oh, who's heard of the character of Anansi? Right, okay. Would anyone like to say anything about what they know about the character in Anansi? Maybe you could teach me something.
Spider.
Yes.
It's very tricky.
Very tricky, yes.
Plays tricks a lot.
Plays tricks. Where does Anansi play tricks, do you think?
He's always trying to get. Things from other people.
To get things, manipulate people, perhaps.
Oh, yeah.
get his own way.
Yeah, get in the other hand.
Yeah, I identify with Anansi quite a lot. Not because I don't think I'm like genius in Rocky Horror, but I'm a musician. And Anansi, at least in this story of Anansi, was a musician. He was a drummer. And he was a fantastic drummer because he had eight arms. He could play all these different instruments at once. But in this particular story, I identified with Anansi because being a musician, you're not always sure when your next meal is going to come. And Anansi, he had a reputation in this village of being a bit greedy. So when he was invited to a function, everyone would love his music, but he would bring his family along, and they would take advantage of what in the trade is often called the rider. You know what the rider is? In the music business, or it's the thing you add onto your contract to say, as well as my payment, please, I would like this and I'd like that, and often it involves various kinds of refreshments. Say no more. But anyway, in this case, it was the catering, a fine buffet, laid on by wedding parties, because he was what's in the day's parlance would be called a function band. He always feels like a one-man band all his own. He had eight arms. Anyone know what a function band is? Function band. A band that's hired to play a function. Weddings, funerals, sort of come up and play your favourite songs. They're not necessarily there to play their own original stuff. They're not there. They don't want to be number one in the British people in it or anything. They don't want to be on X Factor. They just want to earn some money doing some functions, going out and doing gigs. Wedding parties and stuff. Anyway, Anansi, in this story, was living, because this was in the time that animals and people lived all together. And it's the time when animals spoke. They all, in this particular village, this wedding party was about. And of course they started playing on who they were going to invite to the wedding party. But they decided that they'd had enough of Anansi turning up, because Anansi, although he's a fantastic musician, and he'd get everybody dancing, he's also a bit greedy, but I can identify, because who knows, Anansi had a huge family to feed. But they decided that they would conspire this wedding party, and not this time invite Anansi. Because if Anansi came to the party, then everyone else might get a little bit of food, anything that Anansi sort of didn't manage to reach out and grab. So everyone arrived at the morning of this wedding party day. They had to start very early. Cooking, it's quite a laborious process cooking for that number of guests. This is quite a big village. And so they got there at the crack of dawn and started preparing. One of the first things they need, what's one of the first things you need when you start cooking rice, say? Apart from rice, obviously. Anyone care to venture, I guess? I make it all.
Gin and tonic.
Gin and tonic. Yeah, yeah. They might have had some hard wine, but that might have not have gone.
Charcoal.
Fuel. Absolutely. They would have needed fuel. What else might they have needed?
Water,
yes. When I first left home and started living as a student, I hadn't done any cooking for myself. I tried to cook rice in a frying pan without any water. It doesn't work. So yes, how do you think? This was in the days before mains water, and of course a lot of places still don't have mains water. Where do you think they got their water from?
Stream.
Or a river, yeah, stream river. And they would have taken, they had plastic buckets. This is from the days that animals spoke. That's quite a long time ago. Plastics only came about at the beginning of the last century. This was the days before plastics. What do you think they would have used to collect the water in? Anyone any ideas?
Goat skin.
Well, that's a good guess. They might have used that. A goat skin kind of bag, yes. But not on this occasion. Well, I pretend we did. I don't really mind, but this is part of the process. It's something else they used to use as well, their hands. Well, they'd had to walk quite a long way and walk back just like that. That would have been, that would have taken several trips.
Calabash.
So what? Okay. Anyone know what a calabash is? Okay, a calabash is like a massive pumpkin type vegetable. A big gourd. But they can cut them in half and dry them out and hollow them out. What you're left with is a shell, a lovely huge brown bottle. They're used for all sorts of things. Instruments, but they're also used as pails or buckets. Just get the leaves. So, they're preparing their food. They said, okay, we need, first of all, the first things we need is water. And they chose the youngest girl because she had nothing else to do. Said, can you go down to the river and start collecting our water? And be careful as you walk past Anansi's house, Anansi's hut. We don't want to awake Anansi. He doesn't know about this. Okay, but, of course, Anansi didn't know. He'd already made preparations. Word gets around in this village. Anansi had grabbed all their best instruments, him and his family, and were hiding in the bushes by the stream, ready. See, a plan, a cunning plan. And you know the story. Anansi's music was fantastic. If you heard it, you can't help but dance. You go into a trance. Along comes a little girl with her calabash. And as soon as she dips it in the stream, she hears this fantastic drumming music coming from somewhere. It seems to be coming from the bushes, but she can't help. She just starts to dance. She throws the pail down, forgets about the water, dances into trance. Her mind just goes. She just dances until she flops down with exhaustion by the stream, and that's it. As far as this, she's out of the count, half an hour. Meanwhile, back at the village, well, didn't have watches, obviously. What happened to him? He sent Fatima, well, he might have been, down to the stream. But when was that? That was about half an hour ago. Show somebody else. A boy, maybe you go, you take another calabash. You go down to the stream. Little boy comes down. I'm going to pretend this is a calabash. Slightly the wrong shape. Little boy comes down to the stream. As soon as he dips the calabash in the stream, what do you think happens? Yes, Anansi played his music. Fantastic music coming from my bush. Little boy can't help. He just forgets the water. Just starts to dance. Collapses from exhaustion next to his sister. Who, by the way, when he'd seen it, thought, what's going on?
I missed out, man.
When he saw his sister, thought, what's going on? Well, obviously, you're doing it. But anyway, ended up. He was going to go meet my next sister. So it went on and on. Set the next person down to the stream. Next person comes down. Completely mesmerized. By the way, it's a little bit of music. Anansi's music has a nice little song to go with that. It would be a good time to learn. He has some words and he has some rhythm. And it goes away. I'll just play a few first. Let's learn the song first. It goes like this. Pijin to miso, Congo hayere. Ayere Congo, pijin to miso, Congo hayere. Ayere Congo, pijin to miso, Congo hayere. Ayere Congo. Pijin to miso, Congo hayere. Ayere Congo.
Try that together, so that's our little intro.
and the singing kicks off straight after that, except I do the first bit singing, of course. So I'll count 1, 2, 3, go, boom, like that. Right, ready? Like that. 1, 2, 3, go! That's how Anansi got Anansi's ways and all his stuff. So he did come to the party, but all his family, big family, they all had 8 aunts, of course, big spiders. So they got to all grab all the best bits of food. But luckily there was plenty of food to go around on this occasion. So it all ends a bit happy, but they all had a fantastic time. But But anyway, yes, for those of you who came in later, that's the story of Anansi. And it's a story about how I actually relate to Anansi a little bit. Because I do love a party. And especially when there's lots of yummy food available. And I have to say, today's been fantastic.
Woo!
Yes! It's a special thanks to... I tried to keep the name of the caterer, who very kindly fed me today. Because I not only got to play, I got to eat. Diva's Catering. Big hand for Diva. Anyone have any of Diva's food?
Oh, yes.
It was
good.
Delicious, wasn't it? A fantastic food. So imagine that. Band with all the music. It was just like we had today with all the new bloody music going on with feasting. So let's play one more time.
Yes.
Is it that more drum? There's one more drum here. Anyone else would like to play? One more time? All right, here we go then. By the way, if anyone wants to cook, it's a high, can you hear me sing that higher harmony just before? Pigeon do me so. That's just the normal bit, yeah. Come go high, here it go. Higher, come go! Quite high. If anyone wants to do that, that's fine, that works too. Where are the other harmonies you think, Michael? Okay, let's start with that. Boom. 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 Go!
Similar to what I'm doing here on the bass.
So if you can watch this and this, and it might help anchor that in, okay? two, three, go. We should start with that, just start with that bit. And you can play those beats with us to start with, right? And then go.
If you guys want to keep going, we've got more music coming up.